to the Dominic Cutlass. I made for the lawyers. Tell the woman to come and get this wolf bait.
You bet. Want some flowers?
Miss Gorsuch, I got the Bradleys delivered to Miss Taylor Smith. She's real pretty. Your son, Skittles, make it for us. Can you hold, please?
Can you sing? Flowers for upon passage.
Flowers for an entourage.
Flowers for looking home.
Leaving from dinner and for make half a trip tonight and fine. First thing in the morning, we'll go dinner in the morning.
Been down in the dumps ever since his mysterious disappearance. You miss him, don't you?
Miss him? I never felt so relieved as when they told me he vanished. It was like a miracle or something. Not to mention all the money I saved on Epsom salts and ace bandages.
Then what's the matter?
I feel guilty, I guess. I mean, if he met with foul play or some terrible accident of some kind. Well, and you see, it's partly my fault because, you see, secretly, I wished it.
Audrey, don't waste one more minute on that creep. There are plenty of guys who would give anything to go out with you.
I deserve a nice guy, Seymour.
That's not true.
You know, you don't understand. I've led a terrible life. I deserve the creep, like Oren Scrivello, D.V. You know where I met him? In the gutter.
The gutter?
The gutter. It's a night spot. He works there when my night's off and we weren't making much money. It put on cheap and tasteless outfits. Not nice ones like this. Low and nasty apparel. I...
Audrey, but that's all behind you now. You have nothing to be ashamed of. You're a nice girl, and I always knew you were. Underneath the bruises and the handcuffs, you know what I saw? A girl I respected. I still do. Lift up your head. Wash off your mascara. Here, take my Kleenex.
Wipe that
lipstick away. Show me your face. Clean as the morning. I know things were bad, but now they're okay. Suddenly Seymour is standing beside you. You don't need no makeup. Don't have to pretend. Suddenly Seymour is here to provide you sweet understanding. Seymour's your friend.
But he never treated me kindly. Daddy left early. Mama was poor. I meet a man and I follow him blindly. He's the nappy's fainted. Me, I'd say sure. Suddenly Seymour
washed away.
See your dentist, Brett.
That's not very funny, Daddy. You know he disappeared.
Oh, that's right. He did, didn't he? Oh, forgive me, Bonchick.
Seymour, what's he doing? What's he talking about?
Why don't we run along like he asked? I'll catch up with you later. I could call you if that's okay.
Of course it is. Good night, Seymour. Good night, Mr. Mushnick.
Little red dots all over the linoleum.
You're acting pretty strange, Pop.
I had a pretty strange afternoon, son. You see, after my appointment with the lawyers, I was called to the police station.
The police?
Yes. It seemed as though they were doing a routine investigation into the mysterious disappearance of this motorcycle dentist. And when they did, what else would they find but a mustard skid row florist bag in his office?
What's that supposed to mean?
That's what I asked myself, Seymour. Then I started noticing strange things happening around here. Little red dots all over the linoleum!
I spilled some Hawaiian punch and it stained.
It's hard to keep things clean around here, isn't it? Especially when they only take the garbage out once a month!
What are you talking about?
If you want to get rid of something fast, it's best not to dispose of it on Skid Row.
What are you doing?
This! A dentist uniform! I saw it last week and didn't think twice.
You know just what you've done.
And the little red dots seemed innocent enough.
You got no place to hide.
And I catch you kissing the dentist's girlfriend.
You got nowhere to run.
And it begins to look like a movie.
You know the life of crime.
Well, she's on her way. You move in. Is that right?
I think it's supper time.
I'm innocent.
Okay. How do you explain this?
A picture of a baseball cap?
Your baseball cap! The police showed it to me and asked if I could identify it.
Did you?
Of course not, Seymour. They don't know a thing about you. They don't know about the little red dots, the dentist uniform, the girlfriend.
I didn't do it.
Then go to the police and tell them that. Just so my consciousness will rest easy.
You know he's on your train.
Otherwise, I'll have to go and tell them myself.
He's gonna turn you in.
Now, will you come?
They're gonna put you in jail.
Okay.
He's US deeper for my supper time.
Well, look up. Well. Let's go.
Wait, aren't you gonna collect the dish receipts to deposit in the morning?
For the safe, did you?
No.
Well, why not?
I think that's a combination.
Seymour, it's thousands of dollars. Where is it?
In the plant.
The money's in the plant?
I thought it was a safe place. No secret ever.
If the money's in the plant, how do I get it?
Knock.
Knock.
Not now.
Isn't she the aunt to his grandma?
Is it true the shop is decorating for the senior prom?
It's all true.
through now, please.
There's another big hotshot looking for you, Seymour. From uptown. He's been asking all over where can he find you. You're famous, Seymour.
Is that it?
That's it, Mr. Bernstein.
Thank you, girl. Seymour, Belmont, sweetie, honey, baby, pussycat.
Do I know you?
Of course not. But you can be happy when you do. Seymour, sweetheart, dollface, Bobola. Hey, Seymour, crowd on your friends, you. My name is Bernstein, and with NBC, I came down here to convince you to do a weekly TV show for me. Seymour, crowd on Skyman Chips. You like it? I love it. 5 an hour on Sundays at 4. TV's first homecoming program. You make a mint and our ratings will soar.
I'm sorry. a tawdry and impoverished as before. She might not like me. She might not want me without my blood. She might not love me anymore.
They say the meek shall inherit. Awesome. You know the book doesn't lie.
Right on the line.
Watch your language.
Grub!
Give me a break, will you? I'm writing the speeches for the lecturing tours. It's all about you. Give me some peace and quiet while I'm telling the truth.
Don't get cute with me. I made you, and I can break you.
Then go ahead. Break me. Do you think it's easy living with all the guilt?
Oh, cut the crap and bring on the meat.
If only you eat meat. If only you touch a mouse or flies. But no, you're so particular.
Come on, Grubhorn, feed me. I ate Edson's mushnik, and that was a week ago.
Look, just hold out one more night, will you? Then Life Magazine will be here in the morning.
And then you'll find me somebody.
Then you'll never be hungry again, I promise.
Chow Tom, Grubhorn! Food, 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 feed me!
Food, feed me!
Shut up.
Seymour!
It's the matter with me. Don't you think I know it needs food? Don't you think I know it'll die if I don't feed it in soon? Don't you think I'm looking for some way, something, someone?
Seymour! You're hysterical. What's the big deal about a little plant food? You know, I think running this place all by yourself is too much for you. What did Mr. Mushnik say he'd be getting back?
Huh?
You know, in that note you told me you left him? The one where he said he was going to his sister's house and...
Czechoslovakia, right. He could be gone for a very long time. Hey, Audrey, can I ask you a question?
Anything.
Well, let's suppose, just for a minute, that there had never been an Audrey 2, that I was just a nothing, a nobody. Would you still like me?
I'd still love you, Seymour.
Then it's settled.
What's settled? A gun!
Hand bullets, hand rat poison, and pruning shits. Tomorrow morning, after Life Magazine takes our pictures, you know who writes the dust.
Seymour!
Right. They'll take our pictures. We'll be famous. And I'll take that TV job. We'll live a nice, quiet, happy life together. No more night feedings, no more squalling for blood.
What feedings for blood? Bullets, knives, rat poison? I don't get it. You're scaring me.
There's nothing to be scared of, Audrey. I'll take it to that nice little development you've always dreamed about.
And once we're there, we'll live happily ever after. No. Nice little house. Nice little car and no plants. No plants at all.
You're something so peculiar, Seymour.
I'll explain everything tomorrow. Just go home.
I can't leave you in this condition.
Don't worry about me, Audrey. Don't worry about anything. Circumstances.
Feed me.
I will not, so stop asking.
Feed me.
Look, how about I go down to the corner and pick up a nice rare roast beef? Maybe that'll hold you to Life magazine gets here in the morning.
Uh-uh. No way.
It's my last offer. Yes or no?
You sure do drive a hard bargain.
Good. Fine. Done. Great. But don't expect any dessert.
I couldn't sleep. I took the Somnex. But voices in my head kept saying, go to Seymour. Talk to Seymour. I drank some tea. But gee, that feeling wasn't gone.
Your friendly Audrey, too. This plant is talking to you.
I don't believe it.
Believe it, baby. It talks.
Am I dreaming this?
No, and you ain't in Kansas, neither.
Something is very wrong here.
Relax and go with it, sweetheart. Do me a favor, will you, doll?
A favor?
I need some water in the worst way. Look at my branches. I'm a goner, honey. Come on and give me a drink.
Oh my God, I should.
Hey, little lady, nice.
It's like Florida, right?
I should do a drink and taste.
The branches are trying to push me.
Don't need no glass or no eyes.
Audrey, are you all right?
Yes. No.
She's lost.
Audrey, please don't die, Audrey. Please don't die.
You know, the plant just said the strangest thing just now. It said that Orin and Mrs. Mushnick were already inside.
It's true. I did it. I fed them too. To terrible things, Audrey, but not to you,
oh,
never to you.
But I want you to, Seymour.
What?
When I die, which should be very shortly, give me to the plant so that it can live and bring you all the wonderful things you deserve.
You don't know what you're saying.
Oh, but I do, Seymour. It's the one gift I can give you. And if I'm in the plant, then I'm part of the plant. So in a way, we'll always be together. You'll wash my tender leaves.
right there.
Thanks, sweetheart. Wait for me. Grubhorn? Seymour Grubhorn?
Leave me alone.
Patrick Martin, Licensing Marketing Division, World Botanical Enterprises. I've got a gilt-edged proposition for you, boy.
I don't want to hear it.
Let me explain in more detail. It's a very simple licensing deal. We take some cuttings, develop little audio tubes, sell them to florists across the nation. Before you know it, every household in America will have them. I've got a truck waiting and some pots. If you don't mind, we can go ahead and start taking some cuttings. I mean, with the right advertising, this could be bigger than hula hoops.
Bigger than hula hoops?
Much bigger.
Every household in America. That's what you had in mind all along, isn't it?
No shit, Sherlock.
We're not talking about money and plenty. We're talking about world conquest.
And I want to thank you.
Your mother would so much feed me.
You ain't the only thing I ever loved.
Too bad.
But in that part, I'll pack you to bits. Open up, open up, open up, open up.
Events which bore a striking reason.
Thank you.